an hour-long edition of KETV News Watch 7 to 10. I'm Rob McCartney.
And I'm Melissa Fryan for Brandi Peterson. Hey, they're popping up all over Nebraska, the United States, and the world. Miniature libraries full of free books.
And as KETV News Watch 7's Molly Miles shows us, you don't need to know the Dewey Decimal System to navigate it.
But there's some good stuff in here.
Instead of rows and rows of bookshelves.
This is so cute. It really is.
Donna Olish's library is modest and charming.
I love reading. I don't know what I would do if I couldn't read.
At Pat Little's, no library card is required, and there are no fines.
The deep parts core.
In fact, library users are encouraged to take any book they want and keep it.
And you don't even have to return a book. Just take a book.
The women are among many caretakers of the growing phenomenon of little free libraries.
I've had workmen come by and pick up trucks and stop. And if they see us, they say, can we take a book? And I say, certainly, that's what it's here for.
The tiny boxes are designed to promote literacy and a love of reading.
The Chabim, the five people you meet in heaven. So there's a variety of genres.
You may be asking yourself, what happens if someone steals all of the books?
You can't steal when it's free. And so it's like, no, if you want that many books, okay, I'll just fill it back up.
And thanks to others in the neighborhood who have also gotten involved, open spaces don't stay for long.
There's probably only three books right now that are mine. The rest of the books other people have donated.
Which means the books in the library are constantly changing.
It's a good idea.
I want this.
Well, mostly.
I really shouldn't tell you, but like Shakespeare has been there since day one. Shakespeare's not moving.
Books may collect dust in regular libraries, but not in Olish's.
It's valuable real estate, and if you haven't made the cut in 6 months, and if you haven't disappeared, you're out of here. Shakespeare will be rolling in his grave.
With Shakespeare as an exception, the libraries give new life to books that would otherwise spend their days in boxes or on coffee tables.
They're getting recycled. They're just going on to happier places. More people read.
Getting more people to read. A small library, but a big impact.
What a way to share reading.
In Omaha, Molly Miles, KETV News Watch 7.
It's a great idea, and who doesn't love to share a good story?
No kidding. It's all about sharing and borrowing. And
yeah, passing it on.
Absolutely. Well, there are estimated 5,000 to 6,000 little free libraries around the world. If you want to learn more about this movement or to start your own, we've set up a link at KETV.com.